$330. This is how much money my Steam game, Midnight Arrow, made so far. Well, actually, the reality is a little different. So, if you also want to one day release a game on Steam, let me share with you how my launch went, what you can expect from your launch, and my thoughts on using the Steam platform. Let's go! Before we get to the money, let's first look at how many copies of the game I have sold so far. So, 76 sales so far, after 2 months. The number is not very big indeed, but I instead more than doubled my wishlist number after launch. 1,368 wishlists. And it probably has to do with the fact that Steam will show your game to more people during the launch period. And you can actually take advantage of that visibility multiple times per game. Every time you make a big update, you can request Steam to give you a visibility round. And you can request up to 5 visibility rounds. So I will definitely use this when I update the game. Now I hope that these wishlists will convert to sales when I make a discount for the game to make some more sales. Speaking about sales, let's look at a monetary aspect. So usually, you can expect to make most of your money in the first month after release, and less money after that. So far, the release didn't go that well financially. From this money that you see here, Steam will actually take some more. So I actually only got $188. That were actually just enough to cover the cost of me making the game. Steam asks you for $100 for publishing your game there. And they also spend some more for some art and the song of the game. So hopefully, I'll get some more sales when I make a discount for the game. Now you might remember Palmride, a game made by a friend of mine. He got more than 10 times more money than I did with my game. So, it is totally possible to earn a decent amount of money from making games. So, it is good that I didn't lose any money, at least. But if you take into consideration the fact that it took me 3 years to make this game, it doesn't sound that good. Don't get discouraged yet though. I think that all in all, I had learned a lot of useful information that you can only learn from experience. So I would still recommend doing something like this. Think about it. You need to make a complicated software. It needs to be very big. It needs to be of very high quality. You have to be able to update it. It has to work for many users. You have to learn marketing. And the list goes on. I have a video on details like this if you are curious, where I also give some more resources so you can learn how to make your Steam page and market it. But I will say that the most important tip is to choose a game that doesn't take long to make, like I did. It will take a lot of time to make your first Steam game, but it could take only a year rather than 3 years. Okay, let's look at player feedback for Midnight Arrow. It is good to have at least 10 reviews to your game. Otherwise, Steam might consider your game an asset flip, and it will just start hiding it. So let's see what does this comment say. Subscribe to low level game dev because I know where you live. Oh sh**. From the looks of it, I got only one negative comment from a guy that didn't like the puzzles from the game. And well, I have to say, it is definitely difficult to make good puzzles, and I spent a ton of time on puzzle design, and they are still not perfect, but I'm glad that the other people seem to like them. If you would like to see a puzzle design video, let me know. Now looking at the other comments, it seems like many people appreciated the fact that the movement feels very smooth and well made. Now I did make the game from scratch in C++, but you have to take into consideration that even if you make your game in Unity, or from scratch, you still have to spend a lot of time making it feel smooth, especially if it is a platformer. Using the Unity physics, just as they are, for a platformer, will get you the worst possible platformer movement. So that's why I think engines are overrated for 2D games at least. You still have to work a lot if you want to publish that game. So let's talk a little about the Steam's platform, and after that, my final thoughts if you want to make your own indie game. First, if you are not sure if you choose Steam, well, it is the biggest platform, so it will reach to most people. So I would say use itch.io if you want to publish your free games. Actually, you should do that right now. It is a big confidence boost to publish your first ever free game. And if you don't have any games right now to publish, I have a video to help you with that. If you want to use other platforms than Steam to publish your game, do that if you manage to make some special deal with them, like an exclusivity agreement, where you agree to publish your game only on their platform for some money or something. Now getting back to Steam, to publish a game on Steam, you need to make an account on Steamworks, pay an $100 fee, and make a page for your game. Making the page is fortunately self-explanatory, and Steam even gives you a list of to-dos. Keep in mind that it is very big, and it will take you an entire day of work to finish it, even with the art already ready. This step is important, however, because this is what your potential customers will see. What I didn't like about their platform is the fact that it is very hard to find anything. I literally had to search online how to find the specific page that I needed. And their website didn't even help me, I found my answer on Reddit. So what about you then? Well, even though the process is complicated, it is straightforward. So don't get scared because you don't know how to fill the Steam papers and stuff. Just do things step by step, and you'll eventually reach the end. And while you can expect to make some money if your game is very interesting, and get lots of attention, it's okay if you don't make much. You'll still learn a ton, and you can expect to do way better in your second game. I think that no one made millions with their first game, but maybe with their second game. And trust me, no one made their second game without making their first game first. So start working at it. So go check out this video next, to learn more tips and never give up your dreams.